Fusion Radio with Bryan Stinson and YTS Keys, man. I got my brother, man. He's a reggae artist, and I can't wait to tell him how this is so special for me, man. Like, those of you that listen to the radio show on a regular basis know that at one point, I host a really, really dope reggae show back in the day. So we're going to get into that. Bryan Watson here, man, got a brand new single. Man, just like really excited about getting into your movement, man. We got to talk about Cleveland. How you make your way to Cleveland?
So I got family born and raised out here. So my mom and my dad were raised out here in Cleveland. And so I decided to come out here and, you know, check my aunties and my cousins, you know, check out my family roots.
Now, you're originally from where?
Originally from Orange County, from Southern California. So, you know, I grew up in Huntington Beach, you know, the bunch of surfers and, you know, beach vibes. Played a lot of reggae music down there, a lot of reggae music down in Long Beach and things like that. So, you know, eventually made my way out here after touring country with Pato Bantan, Grammy-nominated artist from the UK. Decided to transplant myself out here in Cleveland, Ohio.
Talk to me, man, about, man, when you transitioned to Cleveland.
It was definitely an adjustment. You know, Huntington Beach versus Cleveland is definitely two different places. But, you know, the family vibe is still the same. You know, I'm a strong believer of where you go. If you treat people good, you have good vibes, you know, you wind up getting that in return. So really, I would say the weather was the biggest adjustment. The blessing in disguise was the cost of living. You know, the cost of living between Huntington Beach and Cleveland, way different. So I'm actually able to build my own recording studio out here in Cleveland, where I wasn't really able to in Huntington Beach. So, you know, my money just goes a little bit further.
It's Fusion Radio, Bryan Stinson and YTS Keys, man. We got a reggae artist on deck with us, Bryan Watson, man. And, man, want to get to who you are as an artist, man. Share that with the people that's on live and the people on the radio.
So where I'm at as an artist is I was born and raised playing trumpet, playing jazz music and classical music, and then eventually made my way into playing a lot of jazz and a lot of hip-hop fusion projects, then made my way into playing reggae, and that's where a lot of my foundation, a lot of my heart lies, is in the roots of reggae music. After that, moving into Cleveland, started working a lot in the churches, and, you know, got really attached to gospel music. And so right now I'm in this fusion process, if you will, of creating like this Christian reggae format here in Cleveland, you know, so taking a lot of the songs that we might do in church, or also having my own songs, and then, you know, just putting my own reggae feel on it.
So I told you when this interview started, man, why this interview is special to me, man. Every time I could check in with a reggae artist, man, it's real special. So, man, just recently I celebrated 20 years of graduating from college. And one of my, like, favorite accomplishments was at the radio station, man, I got a chance to host a reggae show. And I was thinking, like, man, okay, on a Saturday morning at 9 a.m., like, how is this going to go with the reggae audience? And it was so loyal, man. So many people appreciated him at 9 a.m. to noon. And then we did so good with that slot that actually it was funny. Moved us to noon to 3 to make room for an oldie show, man. So anytime I could tap in with a reggae artist is really something special. So you're here, man. Have to share that with the people on IG and the listening audience, man, because reggae music does something to me, man. It really does, man. It puts me in a really good space, man, and everything. So I wanted to get into with you. You sort of alluded to it a little bit in the beginning, but, like, who are some of the artists that inspired you to want to make reggae?
Wow. Inspiration. So I would have to go with Ross Michael and the Sons of New York. That's where I got a lot of my foundation, like, you learn about Nyabingi music, so that's real roots right there. You know, I grew up listening to Pato Bantan, Steel Pulse, Oswald, Third World, Burning Spear, Gregory Isaacs, Shinehead, a lot of classic artists, John Holt, Alton Ellis. Like, I really loved my the ska music and the rocksteady music. So, yeah, Alton Ellis, Derek Morgan, Phyllis Dillon, Scottalites, those bands were crucial in my foundation in learning reggae music.
So you're releasing this debut single. It's entitled Right Now, man. Give us some information on Right Now, and then, of course, we're going to jump into it and let the people hear it on IG and on the radio.
It's a really on-time kind of song. You know, when you listen to the song, it really transports you to a really communal vibe. You get this sense of like a family gathering or like one of those outdoor reggae festivals that you remember going to, where it's just, you almost feel like you automatically know everyone in the house already. So, you know, it's one of those songs where you sit back, close your eyes, and you take a journey with me into this cloud of music and just good vibes.
Well, let's jump into it right now, man. It's my brother, man, reggae artist, man, Bryan Watson. Well, right now, you're hearing it right now on Fusion Radio.
Wow! Hey! Here we go now. Ha, 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 ha. Yeah! Taking a trip on the Dub Star Express. Take too long. Relax, you'll be there soon. Enjoy your ride, we're waiting for you. You're gonna be here real soon. Friends and fam standing gathered around. Feel the groove, do you hear that sound? Enjoy your time, the party's sublime. Feeling just fine when you close your eyes. Feel the sun on your face. Cool breezes blowing, smell of something great. Do you feel it right now? Do you feel it right now? The food's got flavor, gonna fill that plate. Speakers started blasting, time to move your feet. Do you feel it right now? Do you feel it right now? Don't be shy. Jump and shout, skip and dance, clap your hands. Enjoy the scene, we've made it serene. So happy you fly to the moon. Shake a hand, give a dab or a hug. Swing a hand, shake your waist, jitterbug. Enjoy your time and sing la 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 la. And close your eyes, feel the sun on your face. Is blowing, smell of something great. Do you feel it right now? Do you feel it right now? The food's got flavor, gonna fill that plate. Speakers started blasting, time to move your feet. Do you feel it right now? Do you feel it right now?
I'm sitting here, and I don't know why I felt like a yoga type vibe. When you hear it, like, what's your feeling? You know, it's your music you created. What's the feeling that you have when you hear it?
So when I was creating that song, I was envisioning being at like a family reunion and what it would feel like, the different senses, you know, what you would go through, like the anticipation in getting there. And then the excitement that you have as soon as you start seeing all your peeps, you know, and then going through and just the different senses, like the sound of the music, like the music always sounds so much better when you're with family. The food always tastes better, you know? So just, I wanted to encapsulate that in a song and share that, you know, with my family.
It's Fusion Radio, Bryan Stinson, YTS Keys, man. We got this really dope reggae artist by the name of Bryan Watson. Yeah, we got the two Bryans. He's a Bryan and I'm a Bryan. So I want you to talk to me, man, about this indie label, man. It's called Dubstar, man. And talk to me about, man, what should we know about in and how did you get connected with it?
So actually, I started Dubstar. I'm a co-owner with my business partner and best friend from California, Luis Reyes. So I do a lot of the production and, you know, a lot of the instrumentation, or connecting with the musicians. Luis does a lot of the mixing and mastering. So, you know, we wound up being like this dynamic duo where we just come through and we can take someone's song from an idea and we'll help them all the way through production, through post-production, all the way out through a release. So we've done that with a couple artists since we've been here in Cleveland, where we've been able to help people establish their first release and getting themselves, you know, cemented in the musical scene and how to, you know, get some momentum going.
So I want to build on that. If you could like build further on that, like, man, take us through the process of putting out the first release. What's some different things that people need to know if they're an artist listening on this live or listening on the radio?
So a lot of things people wind up not realizing is like how important it is to register yourself with the publishing agent and royalty collections and things like that. There's different things that you have to create, like you want to make sure that your business is solidified. You have yourself an LLC so that way your money can funnel somewhere. You know, definitely need to register with either ASCAP or BMI in order to make sure a lot of your licensing and royalties actually go in the right place. Setting up ISRC codes, which is like the digital code in which is like a serial number for your music. Things like, you know, just going through finding yourself a nice distribution company that you can trust. We use Tuff Gong International, which is, you know, ran by the Marley family. And so it just fits what we wind up doing. And I would recommend anyone that could, you know, if you're in reggae, that's definitely the place to go.
So, man, how did you make that collaboration with Tuff Gong?
So that just comes from networking back in California. One of the bands that I was playing with back in California named Better Chemistry, big up to Dave Monaco and Better Chemistry, they helped me with that connection. Their manager is Russell Gerlach. He's networking and like a representative from Tuff Gong, and sitting down with him, I was able to get myself a contract for our record label.
I want to get into, man, like, if given an opportunity, man, what artist would you like to perform with?
As a reggae artist, I would definitely, you know, go back and performing with each of the Marleys under my own name. I've performed and opened up for all of them, but with different artists. You know, I was a hired gun at that point. You know, I'm checking off the first one by playing with my good friend Pato Bonton, Grammy-nominated artist, so that's going to be first. But, you know, I'd love to get back to making my way playing with some of the old roots artists like Israel Vibration, Wailing Souls. I want to go and play with Steel Pulse, you know, my friends David Hines and David E. Lassiri, Amlak Tafari. Those guys are awesome. And then even some of the newer bands like my friends Arise Roots and Tribal Seeds. Fortunate Youth, you know, so it's the playing field is wide open and there's plenty of people to play with, and I'm just getting started.
Reggae artist Bryan Watson, man, is my guest today on Fusion Radio. It's Fusion Radio with Bryan Stinson and YTS Keys, man. So, man, you got this really big show that's coming up, man, that you're performing at. You've been teasing it all throughout this interview, man. Give us the full details on how we can check it out. If we're not, where the event is at, will it be available on live, on Instagram or Facebook or somewhere where we can check it out?
Yes, it is. So the event is going to be July the 14th in Cleveland, Ohio, and it's going to be with Grammy-nominated artist Pato Bonton and his band, The Now Generation. I'm also bringing up my friend Diedrich Jones from the band The Cliftones. They're based in Cincinnati. So they're going to, you know, we're going to have a multi-regional, multi-collaboration going that night. And let's see, you'll be able to see it on Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and we're also working on making sure it's on the Dubstar Roku channel. Dubstar has our own Roku channel that we're going to try and go live from that.
Well, that's what's up, man. So we hear the single, man, and the single, of course, was made available on July 7th, man. So let's get into, man, what else outside of the single can we expect from you music-wise, man? You got a project you're working on or anything?
The plan is to actually release about 4 or 5 songs within the next 6 months. We'll take a break probably, you know, the last quarter, and then start right back up. So it's, I would say you definitely want to keep an eye out on, you know, my Instagram page. You want to keep an eye out on the Facebook page, on the website. For more information, there's going to be shows and more songs coming up very soon.
All right, so give your IG information out. If you got visuals out where people can check out you, man, definitely give them all that information.
Yep, so the IG is a Trumpet, T-Y-M-E. That's like a trumpet time with a Y. You got a BW Music on Facebook, bwatsonmusic.com on the World Wide Web.
Well, thank you so much, man, for spending this time with us, man. Thank you for allowing us, man, to definitely, man, play the new single, man. It's entitled Right Now and everything. And man, kudos out to you, man, for, man, starting your own label, connecting with Tough God, man, International for distribution, man. Like, I'm really excited about what's going to come out of your camp, man.
Thank you, man. I really appreciate it. Thank you for the support.
No problem, man. Continue success on all you do.
All right. Thank you, man. Appreciate it.